If you're looking to build a Plex server or a NAS, you probably thought about getting a server motherboard. They have a lot of cool features, and one of those features is IPMI, or remote management. It's basically a small microprocessor with its own dedicated Ethernet port that is built into the motherboard and lets you control your computer independently of the OS. You can do stuff like reboot, power off, change BIOS settings, and all of that without having to plug in a monitor and a keyboard. Neat, right? Those dedicated management chips even have their own rudimentary graphics cards to show you the motherboard video output in the web UI. And that's where the issue lays. Because in order to make this work, a lot of motherboards simply disable the integrated graphics completely, and that unfortunately includes the hardware video decoding. So imagine my surprise when I bought this Asus server motherboard and decided to put it into my NAS, only to discover that it can't do hardware video decoding in Plex and Jellyfin. Now, just because the motherboard has remote management functionality doesn't mean that it won't be able to do hardware decoding. Some motherboards actually have a BIOS option to switch between integrated graphics and the IPMI chip graphics, but this Asus motherboard doesn't. Instead of buying a server motherboard with an IPMI chip, you can also use a Raspberry Pi and a cheap HDMI capture card flashed with PyKVM. PyKVM is a free and open source solution, based on Arch, by the way, that lets you control your server remotely and even upload operating system ISOs. That way you can reinstall your operating system remotely, without even touching the computer itself. This works with any motherboard provided it has a video output and a free USB port, and still lets you utilize your integrated graphics for video decoding. Raspberry Pi is also way more power efficient than a lot of KVM chips. HP's integrated lights out 2, for example, can consume up to 10 watts, even with the computer itself turned off completely. Whereas something like Raspberry Pi 4 will pull about 4 watts, and even less for Raspberry Pi 0. So there you have it, just wanted to make this quick PSA video so that you don't make the same mistake as me buying a new motherboard for your home server. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.